Alrighty guys, welcome back to day number 3 of our $1,800 a week challenge. Now you're probably thinking, hey, it's bright and early, we're probably gonna do breakfast. Unfortunately, I slept through all of my alarms. I think I just wasn't feeling all that good last night, to be honest, and I just knocked out. And just my body's way of saying, hey man, you're rested now, go ahead and go kill it today. So that's what I'm gonna go with. Now, we already have our first order here from Nando, showing 625, like 2.5 miles. Just an order to get our day started. And we're about 5 minutes away from the pickup there. But look at this order that they sent me earlier, right? It says a catering bag required. It's only showing a 725, like 9 miles, one item. Could not see the item from a street green. So we definitely didn't take it, or honey grass, I think it was. But it was interesting that it was showing me an order like that, you know, because I couldn't even see the subtotal. So again, this catering order required bags, whatever they call the catering bag required orders, there we go, are a mystery to me. So I'm definitely only going to take them if they make sense on the surface, because this order made no sense on the surface. It's like the miles, you know, it was only showing 725. The miles were like 9 miles away. And why would it show us so little? And it was only one item. I can't think of any one item that would make an order over $100, you know? So anyways, we'll see you guys at the drop. Alrighty guys, got the first order dropped off. So now we have 625 in the book. So, you know, nothing like the first order of the day to get everything flowing. You know, the blood, the good vibes, everything. Now, back to declining a bunch of garbage orders. But yeah, so we'll see how long it takes us to get another order. It is kind of weird starting at the edge of 11 o'clock, meaning like I missed out on basically half of the breakfast, like, or not breakfast, lunchtime, really. I don't know. So we'll see how it goes. It's definitely going to change my mindset. I'm probably going to take more orders like on that are fringe, meaning like orders that I probably maybe wouldn't normally take. But because we are a little bit behind, you know, we got to make up some ground. So if I see some nice double-digit orders, even if they're a little bit high mileage, we'll probably take them. But we'll see you guys on the next delivery. All right, guys, I have our next order here from Chick-fil-A, showing 1050, like 5 miles, 5.5 miles, to be honest. You know what? Going to Chick-fil-A during lunch is really hit or miss. I haven't done this in a long time, like going there exactly at noon. So it's either going to backfire or it's going to work out great. You know, because the food's either going to be ready or we're going to have to wait. But you know what? Go ahead and risk it. 1050 is a nice cash flow order. And right now I've been declining a bunch of like stacked offers. Again, DoorDash loves doing this in my area. I'm sure you guys can relate. They'll put a good order with a crappy order, you know, and expect us to, you know, take them, which is crazy. And I'm sure some people do, because, you know, eventually if that's all you're getting, like what more can you do? You know, you're going to take it, right? Except your boy, we're not doing that. I'm not bending over at the will of DoorDash. Not today. So we're going to, you know, I'm pulling into the Chick-fil-A right now. I don't see any parking. I mean, okay, let me rephrase that. I don't see any like crazy parking. Like there's definitely parking. We just parked right over here. So let me just fix my parking here real quick, because people don't know how to freaking park. I'm going to be in and out, so I don't even care if I park bad. We'll be right back. Alrighty guys, so far the gamble is paying off. I walked in and the order was being put in the shelf as I was walking in, so it was a win-win. Now we're 10 minutes away from the drop-off. Luckily, I feel like lunch hasn't really started for them quite yet, so it's not that busy. So I think we did a good job taking this order, hopefully. So yeah, we'll see you guys in about 10 minutes. Alrighty guys, just dropped off the order from Chick-fil-A. It ended up being 1050, just like it was showing. Then right away, they sent me this offer from Papatella. I love saying that, Papatella. Anyways, shows 1275. I think it was like 9 items, if I'm not mistaken. I can't remember the miles. It looks like it was going towards the Amazon building. I could be wrong though, just based off the location on the map or whatever. I jumped on it right away because I saw double digits, 1275. Papatella is pretty expensive, so we get lucky, it could be a nice paying order. But yeah, plus I'm trying to stay active, as you know, I'm trying to stay active. So basically we dropped the order off and then right away we have another order. So hopefully we don't have to wait too long at Papatella. But yeah, we'll see you guys at the drop-off. Alrighty guys, we have the food all picked up, so we ended up having to wait about 12 minutes. Yeah, but that's all right, the order is pretty big, so I hope we have a little extra tip on top. You know, when I got here, the app, when I said that I was here, it made me take a photo of my catering bag in the app, but it made no mention of it before when I accepted the order. So what if you don't have a catering bag? Would it make you unassigned or what? Because, you know, there is an option that says, I don't have a bag. Obviously, I'm not going to click on it because I have a bag. But I'm curious as to what would happen, you know? But anyways, we got the food all picked up. We're about 10 minutes away from the drop-off.
Let's go. Right, guys,
just got to do the drop-off here from Papatella. It was going to the Amazon building. Ended up having a $25.59 payout, so that was awesome. And we're making our way back to the town center, declining a bunch of garbage. And, you know, I meant to look at scheduling, but by accident, I peeped at my ratings, which I normally don't really look at, to be honest. Let me fix this real quick, because I don't think it matters a whole lot. You know, that's just my opinion. You know, I know for some people, acceptance rating matters a lot and whatnot. To me, I don't think it has any type of influence in the orders that DoorDash sends me. You guys have seen the orders that DoorDash sends me. They're pretty decent. Sometimes you could even say I get really, really lucky. But my acceptance rating hovers around 5, 6, 7, 8%, you know. While doing these challenges, I've seen it go as high as 15, 16%, or as low as 1 to 2% when I get bombarded with Walmart orders of this thing called Chef. I don't know if you guys have that in your area, but it's like, you know, frozen meals that you deliver to people's houses, basically. And for some reason, they come out of my area, but they never, like, go in my area, you know. So everything's going 15, 16, 17 miles away. The payout, honestly, doesn't look too bad compared to, like, GameStop payouts and, like, Jenny Craig payouts. If you guys have seen those are pretty garbage. But, yeah, so anyhow, you know, it's just what, to me, that's just my opinion. You know, it doesn't matter. The rating, the acceptance rating doesn't do anything. I think it's just a metric there that DoorDash puts to trick you in order to have, you know, in order for you to accept more orders, you know. But yeah, that's just my personal belief, so you guys can believe what you want to believe. Anyways, I'm just parked here. We have another order here from Honey Grow, showing us $6.75. I think it's like 3 miles. We're just gonna take the order just to keep things moving. We'll see you guys at the drop. Alrighty, guys, we got the food from Honey Grow all picked up. We're making our way to the customer's house. But yeah, you guys can use me as an example. If anybody ever tells you you need a high acceptance rating to get good orders, you can show them my videos. I don't have a high acceptance rating, you know. Now, does that mean that DoorDash sends me great orders all the time or I don't get any bad orders? Not at all. The only way I can keep my rating so low is if I'm declining a bunch of garbage. So I do get my fair share of garbage orders just like everybody else, you know. But you got to be smart about it, you know, because DoorDash will send you the cheapest orders all the time because they want to make money, you know. So we have to... You do the opposite, you know. We gotta be smart about it. Now, in the past, I guess you would say that was cherry picking, you know. In the past, it was a lot easier to cherry pick, you know, because you knew which orders paid you a lot, you knew which orders had a huge payout, you know, or hidden tips or whatnot. Then DoorDash tried to be smart and they made it a little bit harder with the 725s, then the 625s, then the changing of the base pay. Now, all that stuff, I think, was DoorDash's way of let's get rid of these people that are just cherry picking. So I don't think I cherry pick anymore, to be honest. Because now I'm taking orders that I would not take them. I would not take these in the past. You know, like when I think I took like what 925 for like 6 miles yesterday. I don't think I would have done that in the past. You know, I would have just waited for a much better like 850 2-3 mile order. But you know, times change and you have to adapt. But anyways, let me get this dropped off before I get off on a huge rant. We'll see you guys in a little bit. Alrighty, guys, after dropping off the order here from Honey Grow, we're making our way back to the town center when we got this offer here from Chipotle showing 625, 3.3 miles. Honestly, it's not many miles because I'm so far away from Chipotle, like about a mile or two, really. So we're going to go ahead and pick this up mainly because it took me about 5 to 6 minutes to even get an offer. So I can definitely tell it's slowing down. So we have to maximize the opportunities we get. So we'll see you guys at the drop off. Alrighty, guys, got the order from Chipotle dropped off, and then I got this offer of Santini's showing 625, like 2 miles. I mean, they stacked it right away. $6 for an additional 3 miles. I'm taking it because it is in slow times. So, you know, you can't argue with $6 and positive miles. So, yeah, so we're gonna go get this picked up. We'll see you guys on the road. Alrighty, guys, we got the first order dropped off, not a problem. The second one, I don't know what's up. Maybe it's my phone or the navigation, but it keeps telling me that the in navigation isn't working for DoorDash. So just copy it and put it on my regular navigation, which isn't really a problem. That's, you know, how it used to be, but I never seen this before, so took a screenshot so I could share it with you guys. But anyways, we're currently sitting at $62.59. we got about another 5 minutes till we get to the second drop off, and it will be almost at $70. Currently 2:05 in the afternoon, so not too bad. We'll see you guys at the drop off, guys. So after doing the last drop off from Santini's, I basically came to my own little makeshift hotspot, which is in between the town center and Total Wine at the edge of one of the shopping centers. So I feel like I can capture the best of both worlds, You know, but it is next to Tropical Smoothie Cafe, which is where the next offer came in from. So we're gonna go ahead and check it out, see if it's ready. Showing us 625, 2.5 miles, I think. Let's get back on the road. Ready, guys, as we're dropping off the last order from Tropical Smoothie Cafe, we got this offer from Cafesano. Cafesano, we have not been there in forever. It's like a sit down, you know, like semi-fancy place. But honestly, they're really, really slow for DoorDash. So I always try to avoid them if I can. You know, and most of the time I do, because it's either not a good offer or it's way too busy for them, so I don't want to wait. But right now, being 3 o'clock, it's super slow for me. So when the order came in, everything made sense. The pay, the items, the miles, and most of the miles are for me to Cafesano to begin with. So hopefully the food's ready when we get there, and then we can get it dropped off relatively quick and get back on the road. Ready, guys, just dropped off the order from Cafesano. The food was ready, which is a shocker. But then again, the Cafesano was dead inside. It is randomly like 3 o'clock in the afternoon. So yeah, but now we're sitting at $81.59. So basically almost $82. So, you know, I think we're still doing good. I mean, we started basically at noon, so I'm pretty happy where we're at currently. And, you know, I'm not gonna, you know, have any negative thoughts or anything. There's still plenty of time. So we'll see how far we can get. You know, I'm not gonna say that it's not possible to hit 300. I think it's highly unlikely, sure. But again, anything's possible, you know. So hopefully we get busy. We'll see you guys on the next order. Alrighty, guys, we have our next order here from Silver Diner. I think it's 625, like 2 miles maybe. And again, most of the miles are for me to Silver Diner. And the delivery time is in 10 minutes. So I know for a fact the food has to be ready when we get there. We're about 7 minutes away. So I'm not sure exactly how we're supposed to make this this deliver by time, because there's no way. And again, having app issues with my location, I've been tracked properly. That's like an everyday thing now, so I'm totally used to it, which is totally sad when you think about it, you know. And I feel like DoorDash wants to add all these features now with the ADT, you know, like safety feature. I'm like, I'm all for that and I appreciate it, but just fix the damn app. Like, why can't the app just work flawlessly like it should all the time, you know? Anyways, enough of my ranting. We'll see you guys at the drop-off. Alrighty, guys, since doing the last drop-off about 10 minutes ago, we have not gotten any more orders. I mean, we've gotten orders, but, you know, garbage. Currently $3.50 in the afternoon. We're sitting at $87, so just almost at 100 bucks. But again, nothing but garbage at the moment. So we'll catch you guys on the next delivery. Alrighty, guys, after declining about 15 to 20 orders, we finally have our next order here from Honey Grow, showing at 725 for 4.5 miles. We went ahead and snatched it up because it's a perfect 2 to 5 order, something to keep the ball rolling. And luckily the food was ready, so let's get this dropped off. Just dropped off the last order here from Honey Grow, and then we got this. It ended up being 775 actually, so not too bad. And then we got this offer here from Noodles & Company, showing at 625, 2 point something miles. So I'm just glad that we got the order right away. So hopefully the food's ready, we can keep this going, and after this we should be over the $100. So that means we're a third of the way there, so let's go. All right, guys, so we just parked here on Noodles & Company, as you can see back there. And then I got this offer here from Uncle Julio, showing us an additional $6, 1 more mile, 3 items. So I accepted it, but I'm gonna have to unassign it if the food isn't ready when we get there, because Uncle Julio's is super, super slow and I don't want to waste any time, you know. So I'm gonna go inside and see if the food's ready here from Noodles & Company. We'll see you guys back on the road. The food was ready, of course, at Noodles & Company. Then we're making our way towards Uncle Julio's. The pickup time is in 5 minutes, so technically, hopefully the food's ready. It doesn't look like it's too big of an order, just like a couple of, like, you know, individual items and whatnot. So, oh, and I got a free drink from Noodles & Company, because, you know, they're always nice to me. So, hey, I'm not gonna pass up to a free drink, you know, especially because of my headaches yesterday. I've been drinking a lot of water today, so yeah, I feel a lot better, by the way. So thank you guys for showing concern. But anyways, let me get this food picked up. We'll see you guys back in the ready, guys. We just pulled into Uncle Julio's and the food was ready. And honestly, I wasn't so sure it was gonna be ready. There's like 5 DoorDash guys, 1 Uber Eats person for sure, all waiting in the little lobby area. But luckily I just snuck in, grabbed the food, back on the road. So let's get this dropped off. We'll see you guys in a bit. Alrighty, guys, so we got those orders dropped off, and then we're coming back to the town center. I got this offer from Silver Diner, 625, I think like 2.5 miles. And then as I was getting to Silver Diner, they stacked it with an Uncle Julio's order again, and I completely forgot how busy Uncle Julio's was before. It's only 1 item. So we're gonna go ahead and see if it's ready. If it's not ready, we'll go ahead and unassign it. because again, we don't want to keep killing time. So it looks like it's picking up a lot, so that's really good. We'll see you guys in a bit. Alrighty guys, we just got the last two orders dropped off from Silver Diner and Uncle Julio's. Luckily, the Uncle Julio's order was ready. So anyways, we're currently sitting at $123.09. Out of nowhere, it just got really, really busy. And even though the orders are not paying a crazy amount, the fact that I got, you know, back-to-back-to-back-to-back orders, I think we got like five orders in a row. I mean, like, you know, in a small time period, if I'm counting the stacks. And that's all it takes, really, you know? So I'm hoping that, you know, it keeps going. I feel like it is starting to calm down a bit, you know? So I'm going to go hang out, not near the town center, more towards Five Guys, because that's where Bonchon, Noodles & Company, Total Wine, Five Guys, Tropical Smoothie Cafe is. And usually with Five Guys, they like to stack the offers, you know? So we'll see how it goes. I'm gonna go ahead and park, and then we'll wait for the next order. We'll see you guys in a bit. Alrighty guys, that strategy worked out for us. We got an order from Bonchon. I think it was showing like 625, 2 miles or 3 miles maybe. But it worked out for us because it ended up being 975 when we dropped it off. And then right away they gave me this order here from Glory Days, 625, like less than a mile really, maybe 2 miles tops. We just picked that up. We got it in the back seat, so we're gonna go get this dropped off. We'll see you guys in a bit. Alrighty guys, so after doing the last drop off, my app went in full glitch mode. It kept signing me out. I would sign back in, it would sign me out again. I'm like, yo, what is going on? Ended up uninstalling the app. And then I reinstalled it again. I was able to get back online. I got this offer here from Silver Diner and Potbelly. We took it, really, because my app is messing up. And I was like, you know what? What if I don't get another good offer? So we took it. I'm waiting here. Oh, it's actually raining, too, as you can see. It just started pouring out of nowhere. So I'm here at Potbelly. We're going to go pick up the first order. And then the app again, it kept signing me out again. So I have no idea what the heck is going on with this stupid app. It's really pissing me off. But let me go get this food. We'll see you guys back on the road. Alrighty, guys. We got both orders delivered here. From the stack from Silver Diner and Potbelly. And man, let me tell you, it started pouring rain. And of course, one of them was handed to me, and they had no covering on their door. So let's just say I got pretty wet. You can't even tell, but I'm soaked at the moment. And then I got this huge offer from Total Wine, $44. You know, I went ahead and snatched it up real quick. I just parked here at the Total Wine. We're going to shop for it. This is exactly what we needed. Let's keep it going. Let's go. Guys, so we got the food. We got the wine in the back of the car. It was a huge order. One of the biggest ones I've ever done, to be honest. But yeah, the payout on the surface looks huge. $44.33. So I'm assuming that's probably maybe the true payout. Maybe it bounced around for a while before someone actually took it. I don't know. But we'll find out in about 5 minutes. I'll let you guys know. Alrighty guys, hopefully you can see me okay. We just dropped off the order here from Total Wine. It had a $36 tip. The $7 base pay plus the additional dollar for peak pay. So yeah, the amount that was shown was the true amount. I've never seen Total Wine do that before, but that was my guess, because I think maybe they thought no one was going to pick up the order. So they said, hey, you know what? Let's show the true payout, you know, because DoorDash isn't dumb either. You know, they're gonna make sure the customer gets taken care of. Lady was super nice. I delivered her twice before. But yeah, and then as we were coming back to the town center, I just got our next order here from Subway showing $8. So now I got to keep in mind there is a dollar peak pay. So I got a couple of 650s. In reality, they're 550s. So we're not going to reward those customers because DoorDash is paying more, you know? So anyways, we'll catch you guys on the next one. Guys, it's been about 30 minutes since last checking in. We dropped the order off from Subway, and then we got this order from On The Counter. It was shown as $11, 5.3 miles, 6 items. But I had a good feeling it was going to be more than that, based on the items and the fact that On The Counter is pretty expensive. That order ended up being $14. So we're currently sitting at, if I'm not mistaken here, at like $221.92. Currently 8:30 on the dot. So obviously we're like $79 away from hitting 300. It's probably not gonna happen, but I'm gonna stay out for at least another hour, see if we can at least do 10, 20 more dollars, you know, get as close as we can. And then for tomorrow, I wanna set up like 10, 20 alarms. We're getting up early. We're gonna make sure we're out of the house, hopefully by 8 o'clock, if not even earlier, so we can get some of that breakfast in and then have a good day tomorrow. But yeah, so we'll catch you guys up in a little bit. Alrighty guys, it's been a bit since we checked in. Now we've done two orders since last checking in. Bonchon, it was showing at $6, three items, 3.4 miles. The order was ready. We dropped it off, not a problem. Then right away, went to Chick-fil-A. The order was showing $6.25, three items, 2.5 miles. And then after that, we're on our current order here from Glory Days, six items, 3.3 miles. It was shown at $6.50. I just parked at Glory Days. They're still working on it. It's packed. You know, it's Thursday night football, you know, so it is what it is. But we're still making little progress here. It is a lot harder to, you know, record at night. One, it's raining, and two, it's just a lot more harder when I'm driving. So hopefully you guys can understand why I'm like minimizing these clips, especially at nighttime. Alrighty guys, just dropped off the order here from Glory Days. It ended up being 10:25, and then right away I got this offer from Pizza Bolas showing 8.75, three items, like 3.9 miles. We went ahead and accepted. I just parked here right now. I'm gonna go check and see if it's ready. We'll see you guys at the drop. Alrighty guys, it's currently 9:45 p.m. and I think we're gonna go ahead and call it a night. We dropped off the order from Pizza Bolas about 10 to 20 minutes ago. And since doing that order, nothing but crickets. We're currently sitting at $255.17, which I think is pretty respectable considering how late we started today and considering the way our dash was going for most of the day. But I'm glad we turned it around, you know, so you know it's a grind type of day for sure. Six more deliveries than yesterday. I mean, we did dash a tad bit longer, but yesterday we also started way earlier, you know. Then again, it's hard to compare day to day because every day is different. But anyways, I'm going to toss up all my numbers here for you guys to check out. And we're going to go ahead and call it a night. Tomorrow, we will start bright and early. But until then, y'all be safe. Take care.